This clip is brought to you by SaveWithConrad.com.
Let's talk about the big payoff from that moment with The Undertaker. It's going to be a buried alive match in Indianapolis. But the way we start the build here is 2 weeks after his match with Shawn Michaels, we see a vignette of Mankind in a cemetery preparing for this buried alive match. Who do you think deserves the credit or the blame for the first ever buried alive concept?
Well, it was a brilliant idea to promote. The visuals, the vignettes, promotional tools for that match being so unique, I thought was a very viable thing. But then you find out it's harder to execute in actuality than it is to create an image or a graphic or a vignette or whatever it may be. So I was never a major fan of the buried alive scenario because of that, but they certainly, this match here we're talking about, I mean, the people liked it. Seemed like Meltzer liked it pretty good.
Sure.
So, you know, I guess in that regard, it was a success. I know we did a big favor for Terry Gordy through Michael Hayes to get Terry some work, because Terry had, you know, left some bad baggage along the way, which is sad, because he was absolutely phenomenal. As a matter of fact, Michael Hayes had a birthday this week.
Yes, he did. Happy belated to him.
What was he, like 90?
Let's talk about the Buried Alive match. Undertaker beats Mankind 18 minutes, 25 seconds. It's weird. You know, they've built a dirt mound cemetery behind the ringside seats on the arena floor.
Yep.
The ending's kind of goofy. Mankind's pulling out all the stops as always, taking major bumps into the guardrail, over the guardrail, onto the floor, onto the steps. The Undertaker even does a great plancha, and Meltzer says he's probably the biggest guy to ever try such a stunt.
That's pretty amazing.
It was. See,
I didn't know that spot. You know, my style of announcing is best when I don't know the finish or I don't know the specifics. I don't want to precondition myself. Someone says, why don't you want to know all that information? Because would you be able to tell a better story? Well, it seems like that concept works pretty well in the, it worked in March Madness. I don't think any of those refs knew who was going to win the games.
Right.
Same thing in football or any other mainstream sport. So if I want to have that mindset and that presentation of reality-based wrestling as best I can make it, then I don't need to be preconditioned myself about, you know, because you all, it's easy to say, boy, I dread this one. Hear the finish? Oh, Jesus Christ. So all of a sudden you go into a match with that mindset, it's the drizzling shits.
Right.
And we all know, Conrad, that the drizzling shits are the worst kind of shits, because a fart can turn into a disaster.
That's all.
Remember that.
True.
Remember that. So, but yeah, I just thought that I think Mick sold himself. Look, he always, again, I said this earlier, we forget about these little things. He was never late for work.
Right.
He never came to work, in an altered state. It's just, he was so reliable and he did everything the right way. He's the epitome of what you, if you're a young wrestler, you know, who can I emulate? Well, I'm not going to tell you to emulate his bumps.
No, but,
you know, I'm not advocating that whatsoever. I'm just saying he's the guy you emulate if you want professionalism and integrity and to be well respected by not only the office, but I think more importantly, with your peers and your teammates. Because there wasn't a guy on this roster, we said this earlier, that wouldn't want to have a match with Mick Foley. It's just, it's different. It's fun. Mick's style was unique. So, you know, I think that they had, I think when Vince saw Mark's matches with Taker, with Mankind, and saw his mixed match with Shawn, he was really sold, and no reason not to be.
And now they're really trying this, you know, different stuff. I mean, we had a boiler room match in October. Now we're burying folks alive in October. And then Terry Gordy shows up under a mask with a shovel. He's known as the executioner. He's here for a cup of coffee. He hits
not a great idea.
He hit the Undertaker with a shovel. He pulls Mankind out of the grave, puts the Undertaker in the grave. And then all the heels, including Goldust, come out and start burying the Undertaker. And it looks like our Undertaker is finally dead and gone for real. He's buried. And then thunder and lightning hits the arena and his hand pops up through the grass. It's a little hokey, but it's big on sports entertainment. 3¾ stars. Let's talk a little bit about the concept of the Buried Alive match and then how we really double down on the supernatural, so to speak. Thunder and lightning. And then like the finish of a horror movie, the hand punches through that glove of the Undertaker. Cowboy ever book anything like this?
No, no, I don't think we didn't ever have anything quite that elaborate in the mid South. Now if you're going to talk about blood, we have plenty of blood, plenty of violence, but nothing that Cowboy would perceive to be eye rolling. Or what did too you staged, think? You know,
not talking about Cowboy, talking about, Jim Ross. What'd you think of this? The Buried Alive and the thunder and the lightning and all that.
Because we didn't overuse it. I was okay to say to you and our audience that I loved it. I would be lying to you guys. And I'm not going to do that. This is our 101st show. I haven't done it yet. Not going to do it now. I wasn't crazy about it simply because of the execution of it. There was no precedent for it. Now that means two things. There was no precedent for it. So we didn't really know exactly what the guys could do or would want to do in the environment that they were booked in. At the same time, because it had no precedent, it was brand ass new. And so the curiosity factor, I think, was where the markability and the viability of that match came into play. So I can't say as I hated it, but I didn't need to see any more of them personally.
Do you know what the secret of a Buried Alive match is?
The secret?
Well, I mean, you're going to cover a guy up with dirt, I assume.
You mean death? Suffocation?
There's some magic involved here, a trap door and some oxygen or some such, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Well, you don't want to, yeah. This is fiction here.
Right.
So safety first. That was quite the structure, little underground tunnels and
yeah,
all that stuff. You know, I never got in there to see cause you know, somebody ribbed my ass and shut the door. So I didn't, investigate. I thought it might have been a little hair gimmicky.
Yeah.
It's hard to suspend your disbelief in that environment. And again, not because of Mick or Taker, because of how they were being utilized and how they were being booked, I thought was a little bit challenging for everybody to have the match that they wanted. But again, you go back and look at the other side of it and the glass half full. Well, we've never done one before. It's a brand new deal. So maybe we can get by with one. I don't think we ever had another one, did we?
Yeah. There were other Buried Alive matches during Austin's run, but it's interesting. This one in particular, because it is the first one. And I think Mick Foley tells a pretty hilarious story about, you know, this is the 2 hour era of In Your House. So it's a cheaper pay-per-view and it's also a shorter runtime. So instead of it being the traditional 3 hours and maybe $29, maybe it's $14 or $19, but it's 2 hours. So it's less money, but it's also less time. But the show didn't end for the live crowd here. Instead, they've got another match right behind it. So the show goes off the air if you bought it on pay-per-view. But now with a man we've just seen been buried alive, he's dead now. We've witnessed a murder. They bring out the new Rockers. And here comes Al Snow as Leaf Cassidy and Marty Jannetty. It's just phenomenal when you think about the context of that.
That's a let me up match, Conrad. The justification for following something so extraordinary was, well, now we need a let me up match. So those guys fill the role of letting us up.
This is also the first time that the Undertaker gets a win over Mankind. And of course, he technically won the match, but he's the one who wound up buried.
Hey, hey, it's Conrad Thompson. Thanks for checking out the podcast here on YouTube. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell so you get a notice anytime we upload some new content. And go save yourself some money right now. If you're in a 30-year loan or you have credit card debt, it's not a matter of if I can save you money. It's a matter of how much. Find out right now for free at savewithconrad.com.